Hello everyone, Stephen here. Welcome back to my channel. So in this video today, I'm going to be just embellishing a tag. Depending on how long this takes, I may do more than one, but I would like to do this one at least. So let's get to it. These are tags that they're Tim Holtz tags that I've distressed and then inked the edges. Just used distress oxide ink and then spritzed water on it to get that effect. So that's what that is. And this I got from Temu, part of a paper pack. It's vellum paper. I thought it's really pretty. So I'm going to start making some cuts with my guillotine cutter. Okay, where is my pencil mark? There you are. There you are. There's that one. That one. And I got some scraps for a later project. Definitely save those. Those are really pretty. Maybe I can get some use out of them. So my cutter did not cut this quite straight. Let's see if I can fix that here. I may switch to my paper trimmer, my Cricut. There, I got it. Okay, get the glue going here. Of course, my glue bottle is plugged. Yeah, vellum, when it gets wet, likes to curl up. I have noticed from distressing it. Flatten that down. Just re-inking the edges here. Okay. Then I'm going to put this rose underneath. Now the clog comes out. That down. Oh, actually, you know what I forgot to do? Gonna have to re-glue this, but that's okay. It's a nasty habit of mine forgetting to ink the edges of things before putting them down. C'est la vie. Okay, let's try that again. Push that down. Okay. So that's just the front. Now for the back. I took a piece of vellum and I put some antique linen, distress oxide ink, and then spritzed it with water. And I rolled and crinkled up and distressed it. So I'm gonna make some cuts on that. Move that out of the way. Okay. And I'm going to turn this into a pocket, so I'm just inking along these two outer edges. Not the hypotenuse of the triangle. Touching up the edge there. actually distressing. The glue is actually distressing the ink even more. It's the water in the glue is reacting with the ink. It's kind of cool. I like it. Okay. I'm going to put this piece of flour, excuse me, frog in my throat, sorry about that. This piece of flour ephemera down. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Sheesh. I think I would learn. Sorry about that. Still ends up frog in my throat. It's being stubborn. Hope everybody's doing well. Now we're putting glue on the back of this. Pressing that down. There we go. Now I've got this bit of ephemera yardstick here, or ruler, excuse me. And I pre-marked where I want to make the cuts. There we go. Okay. Now for the glue. I'm not gonna. Should I ink the edges of this? No. No, I'm not going to. This ruler reads, aside from the numbers and the hash marks, American type founders. I love all these bits of ephemera. I always wonder where Tim Holtz curates his ephemera from. Where do you find this stuff? It's a mystery to me. Okay. There's that done. Next. So I have this. I took this piece of kind of pumpkin brownish, golden brown shade of cardstock, really heavyweight cardstock. And then I took another piece of vellum that I had distressed with brushed corduroy distress oxide on a piece of vellum. And then splattered it with water and spritzed it with water, and then I Mod Podged it to the cardstock and let it dry. So that's what I'm left with. Now I'm going to make a cut. Yeah, that is some heavy cardstock. Boy, oh boy. Oh, not done yet. Let's see. Got to cut it down to 1.5 inches. Next, get the handy tag punch. Holy moly. There we go. Use some English on that. And we got a tag. Cool looking tag, I gotta say. And this washi sticker is not going to fit on here. Here, so I must make a mark to cut it. I could use my scissors, but believe it or not, I trust doing this more. Got a little bit of washi sticker left. That's cool. Okay. First thing I'm going to do, of course, is ink these edges. Okay, I'm gonna peel off the back of the washi. Or try to. Let's try a different corner. Sorry, folks. Issues. Time to bring out the picker. There we go. Well, there it was. Oops. Now, I realize it doesn't have to be perfect, and especially since this is ephemera for a junk journal, it's often better. It's better if it's not quite perfect. But I at least want to get it semi-straight on there. There. And last but not least, some jute twine. Okay, there we go. Success. He can tie a knot. Whoa, pull off half the twine there. Okay, now we have a little tag to go in the little corner pocket here. So there's my tag. And we're at 33 minutes, so I think that's going to do it for today. I'll be making more tags. I got more on deck, so and I also have some card planned, so stay tuned for those. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really, really appreciate it. If you like what you see, give a like and subscribe. If not, that's totally okay too. And I will see everybody in the next video. Have a fantastic day. Bye.